What's happening? It's another rare video. Yes, it is another video. And I want to talk about the black male's insecurities. Where does it come from? How to get over it? And what is it really? Insecurity. I think about that. Insecurity. Okay, so I guess for a long time I have been trying to figure out what my problem was, you know, as far as relationships are concerned. And the first I noticed was I didn't have a real good relationship with my mother, you know. I just did not have a real good relationship, a good connection. And with that being said, grew for a woman's presence, you know, the need to feel gratified and confirmated and, you know, given confidence, all that good stuff, you know, to create a beautiful man. Well, it was kind of the opposite with me. So this created, in the long run, a string of patterns that either someone tells you about flat out, you know, being direct to you and just telling you flat out, hey, this is something that's repetitive, but, you know, not as an insult way, as in to say, you know, in the insult that you're stupid or whatever, but in a way where, you know, you want them to succeed and get over it, bottom line. So in my situation, you know, I became what they call insecure, as in wanting to replace a woman's presence for my mother's presence, you know. And especially when a woman gives you a compliment, you're a man, and, you know, she's giving you a compliment as a man, that feels good. You know, it's a confidence booster. It lets you know that you're loved, basically, you know. So, in the black male's perspective, insecurity, okay, when it comes to a relationship, it becomes insecurity in a way where you're thinking about a person with another person, right? And you're not sure if this person is loyal or faithful. You're not sure. So the thought patterns become more of you allowing your imagination to take over, giving you suspicion. It could be, it's a possibility. And you dealing with, you know, different types of characters. You have some characters that will just straight out lie. And then you have some characters that are very honest. And then you have some characters that, you know, boost, trying to boost you out of it, boost your confidence. And it's just the way it is. A lot of us, we can't identify with those type of characters in time. Let's say you are in a relationship for about 2 to 5 years and you develop a an insecurity. This could be as well for women too, but mostly for black males. You know, insecurity is not really what you think. It's not what people try to perceive it to be, you know, as in jealousy. Because a lot of times, you know, your intuition is true. Your intuitions take over. And when your intuitions, you should follow those intuitions. You should, you know, give them things, some attention, and ask questions. You know, if you're feeling these intuitions, don't perceive it as insecurities. Because you can tell between, you know, you could talk to a person and know if this person is worthy of being trusted with your baggage or, you know, your experiences. And you want to share these experiences because you want to see if you guys have any similarities. You feel what I'm saying? And that creates a secure connection, you know, and you don't want to lose this and end up being insecure. Like, for instance, you talking to somebody, like I said, 2-5 years, and all of a sudden you can't communicate. You're arguing, you're going back and forth, and you are not sure if this person is talking normal to another person. Especially if you go out and you work in different places. You're in one place, they're in the other place. You know, this can be mind battling. Okay? And you're not sure. This is what it is. You're not sure of being together. That is more of where what we call insecurity is coming from. Is you just not sure. You're not sure of being with this person next week. You're not positive. Because certain, like, who likes to argue? Truly. Like, that does not make a bond better. That shit wastes time. It wastes a lot of time. And you have some relationships where people, they don't mind arguing. They don't mind cussing each other out. They don't, I mean, that's addressed it. This is true. And they kind of feel as though this is what bonds you together, because you're pushing each other to the limits. And I think totally not. No, hell to the no. That is not, it's not even, you don't even have to do that. You don't have to do that. You could practice on being cordial, giving, overstanding, caring for each other to the point where it's not about insecurity. It's about how you're treating each other. Because you can get in one argument and say some shit that you don't like to hear and say that will start a fire in your head. I know that I'm telling the truth. My point is, you know, women, it's always going to be about women with me. That's all I've dealt with my whole life. And I think really this has become a spiritual experiment that the universe put me on. And I just, it is the what it is. But women, are so insecure with themselves that they have to change their whole appearance up. Wow. They have to change their whole appearance just to feel secure. Like, they have to spend so much money and waste so much time in trying to be secure with how they look. They're not most of them, most black American females are not sure about how a person would feel if they just come out with no weave and no makeup in it. They're not sure. They're not sure how a person going to feel. That's on them. Because when you look in the mirror and you have that stuff not on, like you deface yourself, you know, a lot of women look at themselves and be like, I want to change this, I want to do that, I want to do this, I want to do that, I want to do this, and I want to do that. And I'm like, wow, that is where the insecurity is coming from. Yeah. This is where, supposedly, the insecurity comes from. Because a woman can get so relaxed with a man, and you've been in a relationship for 2 to 5 years, they can get so relaxed, they'll take all that shit off and think nothing of it. Nothing. Don't think nothing of it. While the man is looking at them like, damn, you changed. Wow. Now, with that thought in his head, she started making herself back up, putting all that shit back on. What does that, because, you know, think about it. This is how she got you in the first place. This is how she attracted you, okay? And when that shit comes off and comes back on, you're automatically going to think, who is she doing this for? Right. Who is she doing this for? It's not you being insecure, it's you being rational and logical. You're being logical to think, this is how she got me. So I know she's getting compliments because I compliment her ass. And, you know, I think that she's off the chain, but do I want somebody up in mind? You know what I'm saying? While I'm up in it, I don't know. Am I wrong for not wanting to share? Wanting to have a family, a real family, like seriously family, like a loyal family? Like, wow. It seems to me that makes more sense because it makes your life a lot easier. Rather than jumping from person to person, going back and forth, and, you know, all this, woo, Lord have mercy, insecurity. Okay, so this is short, simple, and I just want to address some things. How do you overcome it? Okay, first of all, look at yourself. Okay, I want you to look at yourself, Mr. Black Male. Look at yourself. Notice that you are brown, dark brown, pecan, caramel, mocha. You are in the category of carbonated melanin, earthling, same dirt, same skin. Need you to know that, first of all. Okay, you are the protector of this planet. Can't do much protecting because you done gave it up. Because you're selling out. Okay, so we see you can't do nothing about that. It's far too long. But, okay, so simply feel good about yourself. Feel real good about the decisions you're making. Put your heart towards protecting the things that you have right now. Place your heart around it and protect it to the point where, guess what? You're ready to die for it. Seriously. Like, you ever noticed in civil wars when whites against reds and blue against red and all that shit, Yankees and no, you know, what the fuck ever. You noticed. Did you ever wonder and notice why were these people doing this? And who the fuck were their mothers, their parents, their fathers? Like, some fathers was killing some sons out there. That's crazy. Just to shoot a rifle. Just, I mean, and when I mean shoot a rifle, I mean stand in front of the fucking gun and shoot. Like, I never understood that moronic ass way of living. That fucked me up when I really thought about it. Like, that makes no sense. You stand in front of a person with a rifle, and they stand in front of you, and you're ready to shoot them, and they're ready to shoot you. And you call it a civil war. Bullshit. Dumb as shit. And then they fancy it. Like, they really fancy that shit. They really think that this is the shit. They dress up, reenact it, make movies about it. It's like they're showing their stupidity. They're showing how stupid, how fucked up in the mind they are. But here's the sad part. You got some black people that follow in it. Wasn't even thinking. Shoot all the white people. I'm just saying, this is entertainment only. I'm just saying. They wasn't, why didn't this happen? Now you got the gun. Like, I didn't understand why did this not happen. But today, as you see today, in this time, in this presence, in the social media, they show, always show a white cop killing a black guy, or a black boy, or a black person. A brown, melanated person. You always see it. And this creates insecurities also. Like, this is a part of what you call an insecurity. Like, you're not sure at this point if you're going to live to see next week. So you make decisions based off your emotions. Your emotions could be angry. Your emotions could be sad, depressed, oppressed. You could be oppressing yourself and really don't even know it. But I'm here to say, and no matter what situation that your life is in, you still don't have to be insecure. You don't have to be. You don't have to be. You can look at yourself. And I don't mean look in a mirror. I mean almost like what I'm doing. Look at yourself and cherish yourself. You know, be proud of yourself. And the insecurities will eventually die the fuck off. You know, you're not unsure of anything. You see where you want to go, you're doing it, and you're sure, period, okay? So this is to my black males. And another thing, one more thing. I want to define what is wealth. Wealth is not money. I learned this by the actions of Europeans with their ancestors and forefathers on this piece of paper, controlling the system that we call currency, and what is it? Federal Reserve currency. One thing that I've noticed is they buy time. They have bought time. They have bought a lot of time. And that, my friend, is wealth. Wealth is when you spend time on doing what the fuck you want to do. Period. Doing what you want to do. Wake up when you're ready, when your body says, wake up. Not alarmed and going through some type of dramatic drama, dramatizing yourself. To get yourself into a position where you're on a schedule, that's poverty. You could talk to a bum on the street. And I'm going to tell you, just like I told one when they walked up on me one day, white guy, I don't know if he was poor or poverty or not, but I did tell him that, man, you're in a better position than I am. That is for sure. You're rich. Because you got time. And that's what slave masters and politicians and preachers and company CEOs, this is what they have done, is bought time, bought a lot of it, so much of it that they put it on their wrist. And that's real. That's wealth. That's real wealth. I just want you to know that. Okay? That's wealth. So when you're able to break free from the monotony of a schedule and somebody paying you so much money to the point where you have to keep going just to pay the bills, you're latched on to power companies and just latched on to bills, which keeps you motivated to work a schedule. Okay, not only that, you really somehow you have to get it to the situation where your bills are paying themselves, right? And that's the way wealth works. Okay, anyway, listen. I don't know about this crazy pandemic that's been going on, but I do know one thing. If you have gotten yourself vetoed, listen, ain't nothing changed in racism. Nothing has changed in politics. Nothing has changed in religion. The only thing that has changed is technology. That's it. That's all. Everything else that you see, that you have seen, heard, and it sounds different because they're making up words and shit as they go. It's making up shit. Just like a hurricane, when you're watching the news and you're watching the weather and they say a hurricane coming, they tell you a name, they give you a name, they make up the damn names as they go. And it's the same hurricane coming damn near the same path. Oh my God, common sense, do you have some? Ma'am. There's no doubt that you are going to fall ill at some point through your life. And it might be periodically. Only because we eat things that harm our vessels. They taint our vessels. They chemicalize our vessels. Put toxins in our vessels. Like, this is what we do. When you don't read the labels to shit and you see that this shit says poison, please call poison control, blah, 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 and you still put it inside your mouth, under your arms, around the areas that your pores are most receivable, you know, and that's telling you something. That's telling you something. It's got to be telling you something. It's got to be telling you something. As if, you know, there's got to be a better way of living. There's got to be a better way of having a beautiful life other than just a group of people. You know? So, I'm starting to ramble on. I can do that, but I'm not. Just want to talk about insecurity, talk about what real wealth is, and hopefully there's some people out here that's serious about living a beautiful life. Like, you have the vision of everyone having an opportunity to live a beautiful life. Pandemic is not to be fear-mongered into a situation where you know that this shit is repetitive, it's evil, it's evil. And if you have to stick yourself with something, that is evil. That is evil. There is plenty of shit that the earth grows out of the ground that you got availability to. Like, you have availability to these things. As like with fruit, you pick an orange or an apple or banana, coconut, it doesn't matter. Fucking coffee beans. You pick it and it gives you nutrients. And it could be used as a detoxer. You eat enough of it. But allowing, you know, grocery stores and pharmaceuticals and, you know, experimental, this is bullshit. This is straight bullshit. And we know this. Addiction comes into mind. You know, they get you addicted. You become addicted to certain things. And like Coca-Cola, Pepsi, you become addicted. Coke, weed, you become addicted. And addiction is one of these things. It's only one thing. It's gorging yourself to death. That's what addiction is. It's gorging yourself to death. Only problem with marijuana is you can't overdose on marijuana. You just can't. It makes you, if you smoke too much, you throw the fuck up. That's it. And that lets you know it's a done rap. You gotta hold up for a minute. Wait a while. Okay, but anyway, I don't have a outro. I think that's the problem. I don't have an outro. Wow. Insecurities. Insecurity runs deep. You don't have to be insecure. You can just be yourself. If you have any idea that your partner is not being loyal, or hell, you ain't being loyal, you feel like you're not going to be loyal, or you having issues, then please believe it. Oh no, masturbation, that makes you insecure too. Okay, I'm talking about that in my next video. That's another subject that needs to be talked about. And listen, the thoughts that you're having are false. They're totally false. You shouldn't have to worry about what another person is doing unless you have a committed communication. Like committed communication is when you promise to get back or you promise to do. That's it. Okay, other than that, talking about the past, relationships that you've had, that shit causes problems. Seriously, it really causes a lot of problems. Because moving forward, you can't dwell on what the fuck somebody was did to you in your last stance. So security is when you can say, okay, fuck it. You know, it is what it is. That's one. It is what it is. You tell Satan to get behind you. And Satan, what I mean by Satan, I mean the thoughts that are negative. Negative thoughts. You just say, get behind me. Period. If it is, it is. Fuck it. Sit back, watch the show. And be assured that the universe is going to put you in a better place. It's going to put you in a place where you want to be, where you've been yearning to be. It's going to happen. Period. It's going to happen. It's going to bring, you're going to attract that in which you truly are. Because one, If you are insecure, and then you say you're insecure, you tell them I'm insecure by the little, that's a release in itself. Okay, and being that you have a chance to grow from that, if you mention it, if you let it be known, you know what I'm saying, and then you could determine what you like, what will cause this, and what makes it better, blase, blah, blah, blah. You got to talk about that shit. And if you don't, then everything is going to be suspicion, and then, you're going to beat around the fucking bush, and you're going to seem weird and awkward. Oh, my God, who the fuck want to deal with somebody like that? That's tiring, period. So, hey, be better than that. Be better than that. And you don't have to fuck around. See, and that's another thing. See, listen. Us men, if you got a man that acts like he's not insecure, and this nigga's happy all the time, okay? And he really don't care where you at and what you do, and he does not try to keep up with you, vice versa, woman, too, then guess what? 9 times out of 10, and this is even when you're an entrepreneur, when you're in business, and when you're working in the office, it doesn't matter. Cooking, it doesn't matter where the fuck you at. This works every fucking way. If they're not concerned, then 9 times out of 10, and I say 9 out of 10, is their attention is going somewhere else to even out the insecurity. That's human nature. When a person does not seek anyone else, and all their focus is on one person, you can clearly see the insecurity. You can see it, because trying to be loyal to people, to each other, trying to be loyal to each other, it just seems kind of awkward. People can say what they want to say. I don't know too many loyal people, including myself. I was not loyal. I was not dealing with loyal people. Okay, so let's get that out. Didn't even know what the hell it was until I got older, and then I'm like, wow. You know, what is loyalty really? What is insecurity really? What is love really? You know, you start asking these questions and looking for the answers. Then the answers hit you because of the experiences that you've been through. Oh my God, it all makes sense. Yeah, because when you hit 30, you start gaining common sense. And you know, it's automatic. Don't give a damn who you are, what you are. When you hit 30-year cycle on this planet, wisdom kicks in. Common sense kicks in at 40. Wisdom kicks in at 30. Common sense kicks in at 40. Knowledge kicks in at 50. Life kicks in at 60. For real. I love myself. I love the fact that whoever you're watching this video, that, you know, I really appreciate you. I really appreciate you, you know, even coming this far and sharing my thoughts, my entertaining thoughts, because these are just entertaining thoughts. And I really appreciate you. Thank you. And please have fun with yourself. That way you can have fun with everybody else. You feel what I'm saying? Peace.